My name is Siana Bangura and I'm a writer, blogger, journalist and spoken word performer from London. But most importantly, I'm the founder of No Fly on the Wall. To not be a fly on the wall, well, the whole point is that you are there to disrupt the status quo, you are there to cause some havoc, you are there to interrupt and let everyone know that you are there. And I consider myself to be someone who is not a fly on the wall. And I think with that in mind and what I wanted to do with No Fly on the Wall, I guess that's where kind of the name came from. I've always been a reluctant feminist. I didn't want to use that term, that word, because it didn't feel like a word that was for me. But it was thrusted upon me really in 2011, and I finally kind of took it on and I thought to myself, you know what, I'm really sick and tired of feeling like no one really understands intersectionality, no one really cares about the fact I'm not just a woman and I'm not just black, I'm a black woman. So I thought, you know, and I feel like black British female voices aren't really on any platform, aren't really amplified anywhere. And so I thought, I'm gonna use my skills. I can write and I'm quite good at getting people together and motivating people. And I thought, I'm gonna create a blog, another blog, and create this blog, but it's not gonna be a blog about me. It's not gonna be a blog that only I wrote, but I'm gonna create a space and create a safe space and make a little corner of the internet for us. And I would have to say, really and truly, my biggest influence was the Fly Girls of Cambridge. Fly is a network. It's the woman of colour sort of arm of the Cambridge University Women's Campaign. And it was with those women in my sort of final year of university that I finally felt like I was part of a sisterhood. I finally felt like I had genuine friends. I finally felt like I had a support network. I mean, our key motto is to never be just a fly on the wall. And in all of that, you know, at the heart of everything we do is intersectional feminism. Everything is rooted in black feminism, which is an intersectional type of feminism. It is, you know, the only real feminism that has intersectionality right at the heart of it. It was a black woman, Kimberly Crenshaw, who created the term intersectional feminism, and I think people often forget that. So at the heart of everything we do is intersectional feminism, and our mottos and our values are very much kind of to amplify the voices of black British women in particular, to amplify and centre the voices of those who are marginalised in society, to be unapologetic about everything that we do, to shake up the status quo, definitely, to provide thought-provoking content on our website, to create safe spaces and opportunities to network for people who come to the No Fly on the Wall Academy events, and to create a kind of sisterhood, firstly, for self-identifying black women, and create a wider sisterhood, a wider kind of family for our allies, the woke people out there who get it, essentially, and just kind of be that voice amongst all the other voices that kind of keeps it real and just kind of makes you think about things that you might not have thought about before, or just kind of, you know, educate you, help you unlearn, because I think the unlearning process is a long one, and I think our generation in particular is going through that unlearning process right now, and I hope that No Fly on the Wall is aiding that journey. We've carved out our own space right here in Bethnal Green, and we've filled our throats and lungs with voices, our own and those of our ancestors. From last October, November, we founded properly the No Fly on the Wall Academy, and essentially that's our offline work. We run workshops and take those to school. We run workshops here at Bethnal Green. We do events, we do talks, panels, things like that. I go and do a lot of kind of talks as well. And it's very much taking our message to the masses. And we've been fortunate enough to be able to go international and take this message, you know, quite recently to Germany as well, where a lot of people at the conference I spoke at weren't actually that very, you know, weren't familiar with intersectional feminism. So it's really important to understand that. Just because we understand something doesn't necessarily mean everyone does. And it's important to make sure you're always got your teacher's hat on. And not saying that because you teach, you're not able to learn as well. I always say I'm learning and learning with everyone else. And the No Fly on the Wall Academy helps us do that. So that's definitely our kind of hub for doing our events and all that kind of stuff. And that's the umbrella in which kind of everything we do is is under. Okay, you can be a writer, you can be a columnist, if you want to join the team as well, you know, we have room for you. If you want to come to our events, if you have suggestions for events, you know, holler at us, hello@noflyonthewall.com. All the information will be at the end of this video. Tweet me as well, tweet us @noflyonthewall. And just come along to what we do, show your support. If it is an exclusive event for self-defined people of XYZ, then that's what it is. But we also have events for our allies. So if you are an ally and you want to get involved, please do read what we put out there at noflyonthewall.com. Comment, share widely, and keep unlearning. That's how you can get involved in No Fly on the Wall, and that's how you can start to not be a fly on the wall in your community. Never too far from our peripheral vision, but over muffins, coffee, and fruit, we stew over injustice and our insecurities, and what it feels like to live the women in us. The cars and outdoor chatter no longer matter. Smiling faces and honest eyes accompanied by cornrows, afros and dreads fill the four walls. So we turn to on July the 8th, and we've got an event at the end of the month, 25th of July, here at Common House Bethnal Green, and we'll be celebrating that basically. We're going to have a great panel with some amazing women that I am fortunate enough to be friends with and have worked with in the past. We'll have some birthday cakes, some performances as well, and some music, and just a real celebration of 2 years of Flyness, and kind of, you know, looking forward to what's next for us and our friends. So get involved with that, RSVP over Eventbrite, and I'll see you there. Where two or more of us gather in her name, we create a congregation. Somewhere in Bethnal Green, black women come together and love each other, doing the work of love in abundance and doing the work of healing and defying all that is terrible and all that is terrible, surviving and thriving, existing regardless.